Welcome to Learn Yourself. Today we are going to study about when metal will react with water, which kind of product they are going to form. These topics are under CBSE Standard 10 syllabus from 3rd chapter. In previous videos, we have seen that how metal and non-metal will behave when they are coming in contact with oxygen and when they are burning in the air. Here we are going to see that when metal will react with water, what will happen. All this reaction, what all chemical properties we are seeing for the metal, it will vary as per their reactivity. Earlier we have discussed that when potassium and sodium will come in a contact with air, they will catch fire because they are very very reactive. But gold and silver, they are least reactive. Even though we are burning, they will not at all react with the air or atmospheric oxygen. So it is depending upon how reactive they are. So potassium and sodium are very reactive metal. On the other hand, if we are talking about silver and gold, they are least reactive metal. And in between the metal like magnesium, aluminium, zinc, their reactivity will depend upon how vigorously they are reacting and how vigorously the other reactant are reacting with those metals. So it will differ as per their reactivity. So here, when metal, these two are generalized reaction that when metal will react with water, they will form metal oxide and hydrogen gas. But earlier we have discussed that some of the metal oxides can soluble in the water. When that is the case, they will form metal hydroxide. We have seen this when Na2O will get dissolved in the water and they will give us sodium hydroxide. Similar kind of reaction we can see with potassium also. So when metal oxide will react and will get dissolved in the water, they will give a alkali. The metal oxide which are dissolved in the water are known as alkali. So this is alkali. So this reaction will possible this only if metal oxide are soluble in the water. Otherwise, here the reaction will stop. When metal will react with water, we will get metal oxide and hydrogen reaction. This reaction will only be possible with potassium and sodium. So now we will start from here, that how potassium and all other metal will react with water. When potassium will react with water, it will give us potassium hydroxide and hydrogen and energy. Here, potassium and sodium are very very reactive. Once they will start reacting with water, immediately they will catch fire, and fire is so vigorously that fire will spread out that even whatever hydrogen will produce from this reaction will get burned out in this reaction. So at the end of reaction, lot of energy will be liberated at the end. Sodium also, so violently and vigorously it will react with water that it will catch fire, and this hydrogen will get burned in this fire, and lot of heat energy will be produced at the end of the reaction. When calcium will react with water, we will get calcium hydroxide and hydrogen. Magnesium also will similarly react with water and will give us magnesium hydroxide and water. Here in the case of calcium and magnesium, that hydrogen gas bubble will stick to this metal. So metal will start floating on the liquid. So this thing will happen with both calcium and magnesium, that they will give us calcium and hydroxide, but the metal will start floating because the hydrogen gas bubble will attach to that or stick to that. Now, aluminium, zinc and iron, they will not react with cold water, they will not react with hot water. So here this reaction is with cold water. This is with cold water, this potassium and sodium. So they are so reactive that even with cold water, immediately they will catch fire. So here aluminium, zinc and iron, they will not react with cold water and not react with hot water. They will react with steam. So they will produce aluminium oxide and iron 3 oxide and hydrogen gas. Now with the case of lead, copper, silver and gold, they do not react at all. So this metals are very least reactive, so they will not react at all with the water. Now we will see the reaction of metal with acid. So first, here we are taking diluted hydrochloric acid. So when magnesium will react with acid, it will give us magnesium chloride. So it is salt and hydrogen gas. So this is a generalized equation that metal will react with dilute acid and it will give us salt and hydrogen gas. Now hydrogen gas will not evolve when metal will react with nitric acid, because nitric acid is very very strong oxidizing agent. So when hydrogen gas will evolve, it will further oxidize hydrogen gas also into water, and the nitrogen will get further oxidized into any of this compound, that is NO, NO2 and N2O, nitrous oxide, nitric oxide and nitrogen dioxide. Metal will react with nitric acid, the hydrogen gas will not evolve. Hydrogen gas will further oxidize and it will form water, whereas nitrogen will further oxidize and any of this compound will form in this reaction. Now magnesium and manganese will react with nitric acid, very very dilute nitric acid, and they will form a nitrate of the metal and hydrogen gas. So this is an exceptional, that magnesium and manganese, when reacting with nitric acid, the hydrogen gas will evolve. But the other metals, when they are reacting with nitric acid, the hydrogen gas will not evolve, but it will further oxidize and it will give us water. Now, aqua regia is important term, that when we need to dissolve a metal which are not very reactive, that is gold and platinum. So when we are making aqua regia, that is mixture of hydrochloric acid and nitric acid, both this acid we are taking a concentrated one into a ratio of 3:1. That means 3 part of concentrated hydrochloric acid and 1 part of concentrated nitric acid. When this mixture we are preparing, we can dissolve gold and platinum into it, because being a noble metal, this metal are very very least reactive and it is not easy to dissolve this metal. So this is how metals are reacting with hot water, cold water and acid. So further we are going to discuss about what is the reactivity series of metal and how metal are reacting with any other metal solution. So don't forget to subscribe, learn yourself. I'll see you in next video. Till then, keep learning, keep sharing.